Hi, this is Jan of EcoSummon TV, and I'm here in Hannover at the CeBIT in hall number 16 at the Coden booth, and they have aggregated 50 smart green startups from all over Europe, and I'm going to meet Oliver of Carzeb. He's one of the startups, peer-to-peer car sharing, because of the motto of the CeBIT is a share economy, or in other words, a share economy. So what do you think about the importance of sharing stuff?
Well, it's very important for our business model, since we are sharing private cars. Share economy is the basis of our business model. So yeah, I mean, very important.
Oliver is based in Berlin, and now we want to get a small update. Why are you participating here, and what is the outcome of the show so far for you?
Sure. I mean, we are participating because we are highly encouraged to get in contact with our potential customers, to make people aware of our product, of our car sharing service. And especially, we received a lot of press, which helped us to start our crowdfunding yesterday on SeedMatch.
SeedMatch is a crowdfunding platform. And since yesterday, you are actually a cleantech crowdfunding platform, because two of the startup companies who are here are actually online, and they are raising money. So please tell us who you are and tell us what SeedMatch is doing.
Yeah, thank you. I'm Jacob from SeedMatch, exactly. I'm head of marketing at SeedMatch, and we are proud to be here. We are a cooperation partner of Coden and got invited exactly for the special thing that this year at CeBIT you can not only see the new projects and think, okay, they are cool, this is an impressive idea. You can also say, okay, I like the idea, I want to invest. And so you can get a share, you go to CeedMatch.de, and if you have a German bank account, you can invest from 250 euros and get a share of this young smart startups here from CeBIT. And I think this is a cool new approach for the whole idea behind it.
Yeah. So SeedMatch is, was it actually the first crowdfunding platform in Germany?
Yeah, exactly. We founded in August 2011, and we were the first at the market. Right now there are a few other companies and startups who saw that crowdfunding is a big market and a great idea. And I support that, because if you have other firms doing the same, you always try to get better. And for us, it's very impressive how media covered us and talked about us, and that a lot of startups are interested in crowdfunding. We didn't knew that before, and it was always the question, will there be the market? And right now we know that it is.
And since you started, how many projects did you support, did you raise money for, and how much money in total did you raise up to now?
It's getting more every day, and right now we had more than 30 projects who got money over crowdfunding with SeedMatch, and it's been more than 3.5 million euros in total, which gone to the startups.
Some of the startups had a difficult time finding other investors, but also some of the startups had an easy time to find follow-up investments. So how many of the projects, how many of the startups found follow-on investors?
Yeah, it's you have to share between the startups who got an follow-up investment on SeedMatch. We had three startups who got did the first round on SeedMatch and afterwards got more money, because the investors at SeedMatch, and we can see this in the investor relations channel we offer to the startups, that the people say, okay, we see the financial numbers are very good and we see the growth in the startup. I'd like to make my investment bigger, and I'd like to get more shares. And so we did three rounds on a second investment round for three startups in our platform. And furthermore, a few got a follow-up investment round by business angels or VCs as well.
And you actually started the crowdfunding yesterday, and I'm one of your investors. I invested 2,500 euro into Carzeb. And how much money are you planning to raise in total, and how much did you raise during the last 24 hours until today, until now, so this very moment?
Yeah, so we just started like 20 hours ago, but yeah, we plan to raise 250,000 altogether. That's the maximum, and we are at around about 90,000 at the moment.
You developed a really cool hardware called ZapKit, and you can also give us a demo about the ZapKit.
Sure. So I'm now in the position of the renter. I reserved a car, somebody accepted my request, and now it's the beginning of the rental period, and I approach the car with my tablet in this case, could also be a smartphone, and the car ZapFinger is red. That means that the car is still closed. And now I'm gonna open the car by just clicking the button. And cluck, it turns green, means the car is open. So I don't have to personally meet the car owner to get into the car. And now I can find the spare key in the glove box and start my rental.
You built in the ZapKit into this car. Can you build the ZapKit into any car?
Yes, we can build it into any car, no matter whether it's electric or a traditional conventional car. The only resource that we need is a central locking system. So you need to have a central locking system, which every car in the last 20 years pretty much has inside.
Yeah. And then you do some magic, which is now in the process of being patented. Did you already get a positive confirmation from the patent authority?
Yeah, they had some questions, but they were really positive about it. We answered these questions and we already received a call that it's very positive now and that we're going to receive the confirmation soon. And we took this chance also to make the patent a worldwide PCT patent just before the period ran out.
We choose one more company as the second winner, which is company CarSap. So as I said before, absolutely fantastic, absolutely great product, very convincing business case, great people behind that. And what I learned on our discussion is we really can learn a lot from them also on the technologies they develop. For that is big congratulations and once again I think a warm hand.
Tell me about the legal agreement. It's called a partiarisches Nachrangdarlehen. In English, I found out it's called profit participating loan. So how does it work, this financial instrument?
We had another contract before. We invented the partiarische Darlehen. It was a little bit more difficult for crowdfunding in Germany because we couldn't raise more money than 100,000 euros. And then we changed the model and now we have this partiarische Darlehen as a new contract. And the difference is that we can get more money right now for the startups. And if you compare it to before, we have a dilution for the investors right now, but we have very good clauses on the exit. So if there will be an exit and if the contract ends, you get very good numbers and you can check it out on SeedMatch.de. Before you invest, you see your contract and you can think about it, whether it's good for you or if you don't like it.
How many registered users do you have and how many of them became active investors on the platform?
Yeah, we have a growing number of, and right now we have more than 12,500 registered users and more of 2,500 already invested in at least one startup, and it's very impressive that we have about 1,000 users who already invested in more than only one startup, and this is the number of people who I am really interested in, because the people are really, they think that you have to have a portfolio and a lot of startups and to share your risk.
They're building their own portfolio, right?
Yeah, exactly. And so this is the idea behind crowdfunding, that you don't only support one idea, because you see we have a lot of startups and it's we have a lot of more cool ideas within the next weeks. And if you build up a bigger portfolio, this is the idea where an investor can, in the end, really get money with it.
I have learned you have one current active deal. They are trying to raise 400,000. Yep. This is going to be the biggest round if it is successful. And is there a limit?
No, we have in the first round a limit of 250,000, to have a limit and that the startups don't think it would be, and there would be a limit. And for the second round, it's to be discussed. And that we raise now for the startup, honestly, 400,000 euros was just the demand of the startup.
Yeah. So it's quite flexible. It could even be 500,000.
Yeah.
If you agree, the startup agrees, and everybody thinks you can raise this amount of money at a fair valuation, because this is what I have learned when it comes to evaluating the company, the startup. You try to think a lot like the investors.
Yeah.
And not so much you are representing, not so much only the interest of the startup, but also the interest of the investors, right?
Yeah, if you see it on the baseline, it's always there are two demands. The startup wants a higher valuation because they don't want to give away so much shares, and the investors are interested in a lower valuation, and we always try to get a number between these two demands and get a fair solution for everybody.
Okay, so now he's a thief.
Exactly. Switching roles. So I just break into the cars now, into the car. I'm still happy to find the key, but now, as you can see, the bar will not go up, and there's a lock key here, which shows you you cannot start right now. And this flashlight here demonstrates the silent alarm that we receive in our backend right now, and we're gonna now inform the police that somebody's trying to steal the car.
Now the police is coming, or maybe it's already here, as you could see.